Children, good morning children, this is Ayanna. Today we are discussing about metallurgy, very important question, that is belongs to corrosion. Metallurgy or principles of metallurgy. In metallurgy very important question, that is corrosion. What is the meaning for corrosion? Where we can observe in this corrosion? Corrosion means, the definition of corrosion is the deterioration of metals. Deterioration nothing but to damage the metals in presence of moist air. In presence of moist air, that is called as corrosion. And corrosion is also defined as another definition, the oxidation of metals in presence of moist air. In presence of moist air, that is called as corrosion. Corrosion means the deterioration of metals in presence of moist air. This is called as the corrosion phenomenon. See, once corrosion means the deterioration of metals in presence of moist air. Deterioration nothing but the destroying of metals or damage of metals in presence of moist and air, that is called as a corrosion. In corrosion, three important phenomena are present. Those are, first one is rusting of iron, and second one is tarnishing of silver. And third one is green coating is formed on the surface of copper. This is called about three important phenomena belongs to corrosion. Those are, first one is rusting of iron, tarnishing of silver, third one is green coating is formed on the surface of copper. For example, rusting of iron formula is Fe2O3XH2O. This is the formula for rust. And silver sulfide formation. Like here we can observe the formation of silver sulfide, and it is the two types of substance. One is copper carbonate and another one is bronze. Copper oxide is produced. Copper carbonate and the copper oxide is produced. This is called about corrosion. In this corrosion process, we can observe in the form of activity mode. That is the question is present in our textbook. That is called as the air and water is essential for getting off corrosion. That is the activity. Activity mode we can explain. Those are, first one is A. What is the aim for this question? That is air and water. Air and water is essential for corrosion. Air and water is essential for corrosion. Corrosion process air and water is essential. First aim to prove air and water is essential for corrosion. To prove air and water is essential for corrosion. Next aim after we can follow is apparatus. Apparatus. Here we can take as three boiling test tubes, comma three rubber cards. First one is three boiling test tubes, three rubber cards, and three iron needles. This is the operators are three boiling test tubes, three rubber cocks, and three iron needles. Now we can follow as chemicals. What are the important chemicals for this lesson or for this question? That is, first one is water, comma oil, comma anhydrous calcium chloride. Here one important term is present. What is the meaning for anhydrous? Anhydrous means which substance to remove water from the substance, that is called as anhydrous. Or without water is present in a substance, that is also called as anhydrous. Now we can follow the chemicals, operators, and A. Next one we can follow the precautions. Which precautions we can take? First, used hand gloves. Second one, away from chemicals. Used hand gloves and away from chemicals. After precautions, we can follow procedure. See, here we can observe procedure. Take a three boiling test tubes. See children, take a three boiling dry test tubes. Here in this lesson we can take as, in this question we can take as, take a three boiling or dry test tubes. Take a three boiling dry test tube. Each test tube dropped one iron nail. See children, take a three boiling test tubes and in each test tube dropped one iron nail. In each test tube dropped one iron nail. And give the names For test tubes, A, B, C. See children, procedure, take a three boiling test tubes. In three boiling test tubes are dry test tubes. In each test tube, drop one iron nail and give the names for test tubes A, comma B, and C. In those three test tubes, test tube A filled with water. test tube B filled with
water and oil. Test tube C filled with anhydrous calcium chloride.
See children, test tube A filled with water and test tube B filled with water and oil. Test tube C filled with anhydrous calcium chloride. In those three test tubes closed with rubber corks. See children, first one aim, operators, chemicals, precautions and procedure. In those three test tubes closed with rubber corks. See children, those three test tubes are closed with the rubber corks. Now we can observe a diagram. Three test tubes are taken. Three boiling test tubes. This is the rubber cork. And this is the iron nail. This is the water. A test tube. And next one, test tube B. Test tube B. Water plus oil and test tube C. This is the C, B, anhydrous calcium chloride, iron nail, rubber cork. Iron. See children, here we can take as three test tubes. In each test tube filled with, first test tube is filled with water and iodine, and second test tube is water plus oil and iodine, and third test tube anhydrous calcium chloride and iodine. These are three test tubes filled with anhydrous calcium chloride and water and oil, and first test tube filled with water. But in those three test tubes, so we can drop three iron nails. And those mouth of the test tubes are closed with three rubber corks. And after 1 or 2 days, we can observe. That is called as the observation. We can observe after 1 or 2 days. We can observe. Iron nails. In test tube A, comma B and C. See children, observation after 1 or 2 days. We can observe the iron nails. In a test tube A, B and C. Here we can observe test tube A and test tube B and test tube C. We can observe in a test tube A. In a test tube A, iron nail. Get rust. But test tubes B and C, iron nails cannot get rust. Why we can observe in these? See children, observation after 1 or 2 days. We can observe the iron nails in test tube A, comma B and C. In a test tube A, iron nail can get rust, but test tube B and C, iron nails cannot get a rust. Why test tube B and test tube C iron nails cannot get rust? Why test tube A iron nail can get rust? Means in presence of air and water, iron nail of test tube A can get rust, but in a oil is present in a test tube B and anhydrous calcium chloride is present in a test tube C. That's why those iron nails of test tube B and test tube C does not get a rust. See children, iron nail of test tube A can get because of air and water is present. Those air and water is react with test tube A iron nail, but in oil is prevented from getting off rust. Iron nail and anhydrous calcium chloride can be prevented from the getting of iron nail can get a rust. That's why in those test tube B and test tube C, iron nails cannot get rust because of oil and anhydrous calcium chloride can be acts as a prevented substances. This is called about observation. After observation, we can follow a conclusion. What is the conclusion for this experiment or this activity? Conclusion is air and water is essential. Essential means important or needed. Air and water is essential for getting off rust from iron nail or iron nail can get rust. Air and water is essential. This is called as the corrosion phenomena. We can observe activity.